Nossa, Very good afternoon, everyone. Is that I'm audible? Please check in the chat box. If I'm audible, please put that in the chat box. Yes, thank you. So let me start our session. It's our third session. So last class, as we have discussed about a few things. We have discussed about how to insert a new workbook, how to use a template, and different kind of protections. There is an encrypting, there is an protecting the current sheet, workbook protection, structure protection, and also we have seen how to protect a particular range. Okay, so all things we have completed, and we have seen how to save and how to save as. And we have seen that how to share our document through mail. With Outlook, we can mail the data directly from Excel notebook only. And we have seen the how to export our document to PDF format. So next, we have to go by the more. Under the more, we have to see the options. So we'll discuss a few things over here. So only, ma'am, we have sent the mail of assignment. Oh, okay, I didn't saw that. I was little busy. I checked today. I'll just find it. Okay. So that whoever got a confusion, okay, is then can ask a question. Whoever got the doubts, they can ask a question. The last class, which I have data file tab, other few things, how to use the Excel worksheet. So that if you got any doubts, you can ask with me. In a chat box, whoever got any doubts about what we have discussed in the last class, there is an file tab and other few concepts, and also in assignments, who got the doubts, they can ask. Okay, I will wait for the few seconds. I just find it only the few students, only the 6 students, including me, except me, it's only 5 students. So why this much of students? Where are the others? They don't know that they have a class at exactly at 6 to 2 o'clock. I found Vasudha sended the assignment, and Meghana JS has been sended the assignment. Only 2 student has been sended.
Well, even I have sent it, ma'am. Even I have sent, ma'am.
Oh, okay, I'm watching. Anjal Gupta, right? Only 3 student has been sended.
Anuj Gupta, ma'am.
Okay, Anuj Gupta, yeah. Only a few student has been, okay, Ananya also sent it. Neha Vasudha, okay, she started the class. It's only the few student, only the 4 members. Vasudha, Meghana, Anuj Gupta, and Ananya has been sent it. Only the 4 student out of 49-50 students, okay. I'll send by today evening, okay, I'll see Rubia. So shall we start another few concepts? So last class we have just discussed about the and how to protect and how to use the Excel sheet. So we'll continue by the how to change our screen. So what you can find is this Excel screen. you can be viewed in a different angles. And before me, I'll just open a new Excel sheet. So you know the three mode. One is you can go by the start button, you can select the Excel, or you can go by the window or run button, you can type your Excel. Now one second, if you don't know, okay, the Excel workbook will be open. So defaultly what we'll be having, we will be having a sheet one. So once I have opened, after 2010, we know that we all the applications in all the Excel applications will get only one sheet. If you want, once you have logged into the Excel workbook or worksheet, it has to be, you have to get an literally on 3 to 4 sheets. Okay, if you want to activate, you can go by the file. Under the file, you can find a more. Under the more, you have option. Under the options, in a general, you can see over here default. In a general, you can see over here include this sheet, maybe then one. You can increase it, either you want a 4 sheet, either you want a 5 sheet. You can increase your sheet according to it. For example, I want 5 sheets. Once I have logged into the new Excel workbook, I should get a 5 sheets. And it's a defaultly caliber. Font size will be, font style will be in caliber. Now, I don't want caliber. My favorite style is in Algerian. I want to assign and always it should be logged in with the, when I'm logging into the Excel, I should have a Algerian style. And size is defaultly 11. I don't want this 11. I want it as an 18. Okay. You can change your settings. Okay. See, if I give a okay, it's asking me, please close your present workbook and restart again. Okay, I'll just click a OK. I close this. I'll open your new Excel. Okay, once I have started a new Excel, I'll find 5 sheets. Can you see here? I find it a 5 sheets. If I started to write, okay, it's again is not affected. See, it's an 5 sheets defaultly I'll get. Okay, you can change it where I can go by the file. I can go by the more. In options, you can change it. And also you can find the theme at the back sides and color, that is green and white color. You can change it. Okay, you can go by the office theme. Under you can find it colorful. So you can change it a dark gray. So if you click on OK, you'll find the dark gray color. Akash, mute yourself. Please, once you have login, please mute you by yourself only. Okay. So see that color what it's and looking, you can be changed. Okay. So you can go, I'll just show you how to do it other method. You can go by the start button, more in the options, you can change a gray color. Or I want in a light color. You can select it, click on okay, you get a white. Like this, you can see the and title is in white color. So if you go with the colorful, it will be presented by the green color. See. Colorful in office theme, I'll select the colorful, it will be converted automatically in a and green color. So what you can see that usernames is an it can be changed into the other name, like an NICT, you can change it. Okay. So what you can see the background office theme, you can change it to other color, that is an double circle, whatever you want, you can change it. Okay. So see this is method. See, now we got an changes in a title, but that is in color, but that is in green color, it can be displayed. So you can change your screen by using of this generator. Okay. So other concepts will be done in an advanced concept. There is an advanced Excel will do it. Okay. So then we have a form. Then we have already discussed the quick access toolbar, and we have already discussed with the forms. Just once again, I'll explain you. If you want to write any data on the screen, instead of writing on a cell, you can use official kind of forms tool. Or I can use the forms that you can go by the dialog box. That is, I'm sorry. You can go by the quick access toolbar. In a quick access toolbar, you can find the more commands. You can find the more commands. Click on the more command, you'll find us some of the set of quick access toolbar, which then already regularly we can use it. If you want a more, you can go by the under the choose command. You can go by the choose command. You can select then. You need a form. If you want a form, you need to select a yes. Okay. Sorry. I select all the commands. And as all the commands, you just need to wait, it will be uploaded. Yes. And as all the commands, I want a form. I just find the F series. I'll go by the F inform the F series. I'll go by the form. Select the form. Click on add. Already it's there. In case if it's not there, go by the quick access toolbar. Go with the choose command. Select all the commands. Click on add. Forms will be added. Okay. Click on OK. And you want to write in a detail. Means if I want to write in student's ID. Okay. So student's marks list or employee data has to be filled. So what I will do, I'll go by the adding serial number. I just wanted to add name of the employee. And I want to add another student marks. Then salary I want to add. Okay, so if I want to fill this series, okay, I'll select this. I'll go by the forms. If once you have selected into the add into the and quick access toolbar, on that quick access toolbar you can see over here, click on a form. It will ask about series will be taken. Click on okay. Okay, so see serial number, name of the employee, got a salary. Okay, I'll cursor over here once again. I'll cursor about at the serial number, click on the forms, click on OK, now start writing. So serial number I need to type on, it is an 001 and employee name, that is an Rakshita. And I want to write the salary, that is an 15,000. So once you are given the new, automatically it will be filled. So instead of typing of in a particular cell, you can use this kind of special forms and you can write the data on the individual cells. Okay. So I'll just show you one more time. Have cursor in the next to the serial number. I'll cursor over here. I'll add a student serial number as in 002. I'll go by the employee name. For example, Anirudh. Anirudh the lad. Salary is an then 20k. Just add a 20k. Click on new. Once I click on new, automatically it will fill. And instead of writing in a particular cell, you can use this form. Okay. So now we are going to be discussed in this today concept. This was the concept is a clipboard. Under the clipboard, we are going to be discussed the place and the place specials. Also, we are going to discuss the cut copy. And also, we are going to be discussed about the format painter. And we have a font. Under the font group, we have a border. Effect styles we have, and fills we have, we will go with the discussing this. And we have a alignment, we have a text alignment, and text control and orientations we have. After that we have a numbering, after that we have a styles, under the styles we have a condition formatting, and fill styles we have. So these are the concepts we are going to be complete today, okay? So let me start by the first, what is the first? Clipboard under the page specials, okay? Let me go by the data. Okay, so now we have completed the file tab. We are going to be in a home tab. Under the home tab, we know that it's our file, home, insert, page limit are called as in tabs. Under the tabs, we have a command, that is in cut, copy, paste, bold, italic, underline, alignments. So called as in commands, and set of command has been assigned as in group, that is in clipboard font alignment. And each group which has some of the and hierarchy at the down to it is called as in dialog box manager. In that we'll get an extra options over here. Okay. So first of all, we'll go by discussing a clipboard group. Okay. In a clipboard, we have a paste, cut, copy, and we have a format as painter. Okay. So if I want to do the paste is not activated. Why? Because you didn't selected the data or you didn't copy or cut your data. You know the difference, right? What is in cut and copy? Cut, it will remove the data from that and you can paste wherever you want. And copy, it will remember same. Okay, it will copy the data from that place and it will be pasted in somewhere else. For example, See, I'm copying this control C is a shortcut key and I can paste wherever I want. So cursor over here, click on paste. Or if you cut it, see, I, for example, if I select the data, I click on a cut, it will remove from that place and it will be pasted at the other side. See, where I have selected, this see, I'll undo it. You know, the what is a shortcut key of undo? Control Z is an undo, okay? So I have undo that. So as well as selected the data from A1 to, I have selected the data from A1 cell to G4. So you have to always remember what is this when you are selecting the data from where to where I have selected. So I am selecting the range from A1 to G11. So select the data. So see on the name box, you can find 11 rows and 7 columns has been activated. Means I have selected from A1 to G4, G11 you have selected. Select the data and click on cut. Okay, once you have cut, it will remove. Means the data will be removed from that place and you can paste wherever you want. So just a second, I'll copy. I cut on it. Okay. I want to paste this in a I-12 cell. Okay. I-13 cell I want to paste. I'll cursor on I-13. Click on a paste. Okay. Once you have click on paste, it will be removed from there. Okay. And it will paste it in I-13. Okay. See, I'll just show you the copy. Copy, the data will be remembered same over there and it will be copy it to the other place. Same data I have selected. I click on a copy. Control C is a shortcut key. Click on a Control C and cursor in the A1 or wherever you want in a particular cell. Click on a paste. Control V is a shortcut key. Okay. So once you have said, it will be pasted on a particular cell. Okay. This is a paste. I think you have clear. So here, just give a shortcut key, you can make a note. For cut, shortcut key, control plus text. For copy, it is an control plus C. For paste, it is an control plus V. Okay. So we have a paste special. So if you are I'm requesting you to all to make a note of this. In case of your Conv note, you maybe are traveling, you can just take a screenshot of it. Okay. So let me go with the next concept, that is an paste special. Okay. Let me go back to paste special. Paste, we know that once you have what you have selected, if you copied it and wherever you want, you can paste it. But here we have a paste special, that is NC. Here I have formatted my data. So, say for example, this is an empty data. You can see I didn't give any formatting. It's a very plain data. So I didn't give any header. I didn't give any color for my text. I didn't give any bold or I didn't give any formatting of my data. Okay. So see, for example, I'll format my data. I select my data. I click on a fill style. I'll fill my data. Okay. Like this, I have filled my data with the colorful by the formatting. You can see that. And header, I given a blue fill and a dark black. I given a font color as in black and given an Algerian font. Like that, I have given for the data, I have given a yellow fill, I have aligned it up bold, okay? And also you can see in a ESI block, I have given a percentage and amount in a dollar block, I have given a dollar symbol, okay? So in this pay special, what it will do, whatever you have formatted, if you don't want, in case of hotel copy, whatever I'm going to be paste, I don't want this formatting, means I don't want this coloring, okay? So I want a plain text. Or I don't want this dollar, means I don't want this formatting, that is a dollar, or I don't want this percentage, means without formula I want, okay, I can paste it. And also you can see that in this my data have been a border, okay, without border it look like this. If you given a border, select the data, If you want to give a border, you can give a border. Here we have a multiple types of border. You can click on all the border. Okay. I've assigned my data with a formatting. Okay. So now I'll copy this. I want to paste this data without an coloring, or I don't want formula. Okay, you can see that. Can you see that in this? You can't be view that and percentage. In amount, in a dollar, I have presented a dollar symbol. I can't be presented. So whatever you have formatted, if you don't want that, you can use to paste without formatting. See, you can't be find the border. You can't be find that highlighter what I have given at the back side. I given a blue filling of the font. I didn't find. So I have given a percentage symbol. I didn't find. So like this, you can use your paste feature. Okay, I'll just show you one more time. So in a paste, at the drop down, you have a sum of and small a drop down button. Click on that. You'll find a unpaste special. Okay. So one is a normal paste. A second one is a formula which I have showed you. I have with formulas which I have showed you at previous. Next we have a with formula. You can't be find the formatting, but you can find a formula that is a percentage dollar. And also you can see the border is also not applied. Okay. So this is one kind. So next we have under paste special. We have a keep as a source. What you have copied, same as it is, you have to be pasted. So it's a keep as a source. Then we have a, I'll just use my data at a scrolling. Just I'm going with the next cell. I'm going to be paste over here. Next I'm going with the paste with formatting without border. What I'm going to be paste? I'm going to be paste a data without a border with formatting. See, have a fill it with a blue highlighter. I've given alignment and I'll get in alignment. I've filled my data with the yellow fill. So like this, you can be paste. There is a without border. Next, we have a paste special with keep source column width. Okay, using a column width, you can paste this. And you have a one more paste, transpose means. In this transpose, you're going to be paste your data in what you have assigned in a vertical data to horizontal data. What you're going to be paste? You're going to be paste your data from vertical series to horizontal series. Okay. So see, it's in vertical what you have pasted with the column width. So here you have a transpose. You are going to be paste your data from vertical to horizontal. Okay. There's one more paste special you can use. I'll cursor over here. I'll go with the one more paste special. There is an name, same as it is in 3. What is that? Formula without formula. Okay. Next we have a formatting. Okay. Here, can you see the data? What I've given in a serial number, employee ID, employee name, designation. You can't find the data. Only the formatting things will be pasted. Okay. So if I started to write over here, for example, I want to write a student ID. That is an, I'll write a ID. Okay. So what I have given and style on the before of the previous cell, the same thing it will be copied over here. Okay. So this is a paste special. That is a without data with formatting. Okay. I'll copy this again. I'll paste over here. Okay. Paste special. Next, you have a link pasting. Whatever you'll get the URL address. Okay. You know that what is a URL address. You go by your Google, you'll search some data. For example, I'll want to find a NICT computer education. I'll find it. So at some of the, and I'll find some web page. I want to copy this data. I'll just copy this address. I'll go by the Excel. I'll paste this. If you want to paste this using a paste special, you can use a paste special. With the link, you can paste it. Okay. Like in, you can paste like a name. Okay. These are the other paste specials you can do. Okay. I'll copy the same data. Copy. I'll go by the paste. This is paste as a link. Next, you have a paste as an image. What you have before you have pasted, there is a different kind. Okay. So that in other format, you can edit your data. Okay. For example, I can edit this data. For example, in a designation, I will add over here HR. But what you have pasted in image format, okay? whatever you have pasted in image format, that you can't be edit, but you can be take wherever in the Excel sheet. Okay, just here I'm zooming out. So wherever you want this pasted things or paste as an image format, you can drag it. Okay, you can assign wherever you want, or you can extend the data by using of the edge pointer. Okay, this is your and paste special. One more paste specials we have, paste like a link as an image. Okay, whatever you have copied an image, that you can be pasted as an image. This one you can paste as an image. Okay, this is a paste special. The shortcut key we have, this I'll provide over here. Control plus and paste special. Control plus shift plus V. It's a shortcut key for paste special. I'll just show you. I'll just go by the Excel sheet. Okay, now I'll go by over here. I'll cursor over here. Okay, I'll copy, I'll click on a control plus shift plus V. Okay, sorry, control plus alt plus V. Okay, make a change of here. Control plus alt plus V. Okay, control plus alt plus V for special. Whatever you have done there with formula, with value, formatting, command, validation, still we didn't that one. We'll do it later towards and transpose all the special paste will get. This add, subtract, multiplication, division will do over in an advanced Excel. Okay, so then this is a paste special. So anything doubts in this? Any doubts you have in this paste special? You can chat by in a chat box. What we have did the paste special, you can chat. If you have a got doubt, you can chat in a chat box.
Can you show me that formula chart?
Formula chart. Okay, fine. That is a shortcut you can use, or you can go by the paste. You can go by the paste special, the down towards only you have. You can see that control plus alt plus E, V is a shortcut key. Is an only.
I'll just take a screenshot of it, ma'am.
I'll just send a our video record, right? Why you want this screenshot? We'll link an YouTube link. Whatever the class today we are doing, we'll send a link to you. Don't worry, okay? Isn't pay special? Or we'll do other few comments.
Send to YouTube, ma'am.
Yes, we'll send a link to you. So last two classes we didn't send it. So what we'll do the today class within a 2 days, we'll upload it to your group, okay? We'll give a YouTube link. We'll be uploaded, okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, this is pay special. Okay, this I'll show you one more time. I'll copy the previous data. Yes. I'll just scroll over right towards. I'll just copy this. I'll just cover the any blank cell. Yes. I'll just cover in a blank cell. Go by the paste special. This is a paste anomaly. Next, we have a paste without formula. Paste with formula. Keep source as formatting. Without border paste. The second. And without border paste, you cannot be find a border when this you are going to be pasted. This is a keep source as in normally. This is a transpose, that it will be converted your horizontal data to the vertical. Okay, this is the same above the value. And this is a paste with formatting without data. Paste the link. Whatever you have copied, the URL address, it can be pasted over here. And this is a paste like a picture. In this format, you cannot be edited anything. You can drag it wherever you want. Paste link as an image. Okay, these are the paste features we have. Okay. So I think it's clear. Shall we go with the next concept? So cut and copy we have clear. Next we have a format painter. Okay, next we'll let me go with the shifted to the next cell. See, concentrate on this range. So in this range, in a employee ID, that is a shortcut form, employee ID. For ID number has been highlighted by using of some of the format. It is an blue text, has given a font highlighted by the 16 size, and has given the bold, and has given a cream highlighter. Okay, whatever have given a highlighting, it has to be copied for other my ID numbers. So how I can copy that? Either you can use an format as Painter. Okay, you know that what is in formatting, whatever you're going to be changed or whatever you're going to be highlight your data, that is called as in formatting. Same thing, it has to be painted for other text. Okay, there's a two types. One, you have selected the one time in the format Painter, it will be applicable only one time. If you have double tap on the format Painter as in twice, the same thing you can be selected at the twice or thrice, or how many times you want you can be user. Just I'll show you. I want to copy this ID number, that is 6803. Whatever I have highlighted is then through A2 cell. Same thing has to be applied for other my employee ID. Okay. I just select my data, that is the reason already formatted. Click on a format Painter as in one. You need to just tap one time on a format Painter. Okay. Once you have selected the format Painter, on your cursor you can find a paint brush. Okay, can you see that you have a paint brush? Okay, so that paint brush is indicating you are going to be formatting, or you are going to be doing the format Painter to the other text. Whichever text you select, automatically it will be formatted what you have assigned. You can see that 7301, it has a date. I just click on it, what it have a formatted for the first thing, same it will be copied. See, for example, my higher authority or my other colleague has been defined the data with a beautifully. Same thing that has to be assigned for the other document or other data, but I don't know which are the format he has been read. So I want to copy the same thing for the my data also. You can use this techniques to use. Okay, just show you one more time. Select that for that company name, I'm just selecting IBM. I'm selecting same IBM. I want to be highlighted the same formatting. Select that, click on a format Painter at the one time, tap on a format Painter one time, and on the IBM only, I'll just tap on it. Just see, I click on a one time, it will be changed. The same thing which should be repeated at the three times or four times. Select the data which is an already formatted. Double tap on a format Painter. Okay, what you have to do if you want to regularly use, or if you want to use this and randomly, so double tap on the format Painter. Okay, so select the value whatever times you want. I want to apply this same data, same formatting on HP, same thing on the HP, same other things for the HP. You can select it or you can tap on the data. Okay, this is an format Painter. Okay, still see the format Painter is activated. You can see on my cursor, so it's an brush icon is an highlighted. It's nothing but different format. You are going to be formatting your data if you don't want, so you just unclick on a format Painter. Once it will be removed. So okay, I'll just show you one more time. I have formatted my data. Just go with the format Painter, select the data which is already formatted. If you want to only format it at a one time, you just click on a one, tap on a one time on a format Painter. If you want to use them regular, or if you want to use them multiple times, double tap on a format Painter. Okay, this I'm doing now, double tapping on it, double tap on it, select the range which you want to be formatted, or you can select a plain cell also, whatever you're going to be write on that. For example, I want to write a HP. So once I have written the HP, automatically it will be followed the same font style. Okay, I think you have clear. So same, I'll just use on one more thing. I select the IBM, I just double tap on it. You can select the set of range, it has to be copied the same formatting. I think you have clear, right? This is an format Painter, means you're going to be formatting your data to one more or plain text. Okay, this is an format Painter. Next we have a font. Okay, so in our clipboard, we have completed Pay Special, we have completed a format Painter. So next we have to go with the font group. Under the font group, first we have to complete the border, then font effects, font style, and fill. Okay, let me go by the Excel sheet. Because since we want wherever cursor in other sheet also for cursor, it will be same formatting. If you want to come back of that, you need to click on a format painter only. Once you have to click on a format painter, it will be removed. Okay. So next, let me come to the font. Okay. So in a font group, we used to format my data, or I want to be highlight my data with differently. You can go by this font. Okay. In this font, you have a first, you have a style. In all the Microsoft application, the font style will be always in a caliber body, okay? Where it will be the caliber body. And size, it will be defaultly, and 11 will be there, okay? So if you want to change, you can change. And largest size is 72, okay? The last size is 72. You can increase it after also. And you can find over here, my font size is starting by the 8. 9, 10, 11, 12. You didn't find the 13. See that 13 is skipped. 14 is there. 15 is not there. So if you want to change, that means I want a 17 size only. Can't find here. It's in containing the 16. It's an containing by the odd number, even numbers. Okay. I want that 17 size only. You can go by over here. You can type this 17. You can click on a enter. Okay. Once you are click on enter, automatically you can find it in 70. Okay. So this is your format. So it is a font size. Okay. Next you have, it's a font increment and font decrement. Just select this. This then have selected the some data. This is an world richest person. That is an 2021 richest person have selected. There is a billionaire list. Okay. So select the data. This data has to be highlighted in this data. So I've selected a sample data. This is an I want to be give this as a chart format. So if I want to highlight this chart format, I have to select the heading. Heading should be always has to be highlighted. So what I'll do, I'll click on a increasing of font. Either you can go by the size changing, or you can click on a increasing of font. Or you can, if you want to decrease, you can go by the decrease. Or if you want to select a particular size, if you want 15 only, or if you want 15.5, you can assign 15.5. I want a size. You can change it. And also this heading, it has to be the billionaire list. It has to be assigned as a heading. So I'll select the other form of heading. So we have a different kind of style. Select the style. Okay. This is billionaire list. So I want to be highlighted this even more. So you have a board. You can use a shortcut key Control B. I've used the shortcut key Control B, or you can click on this B. Okay, B is nothing but it's a board. Okay, you're going to be highlighting your letter by the board. Okay, just click on a board. Okay, it will be highlighted. Okay, then italic. It is also a kind of style, and you have a underline. Underline, you have a two types. One is a single underline. One is a double underline. Which format you want, you can select it. Single line will be underlined by the single. If you click on a double underline, it will be underlined by the double line. Okay. So this is your font. Okay. So I want to be highlight this rank by the italic. Okay. So I want to be highlight this names by the bold. Okay. So I can be highlighted. And I want to be highlight this ranks by the and font style. Okay. This is a fill style. It's an, if you want to, this is a header. If you want to highlight this header by the back side, means I want to be highlight like a marker, or I want to be highlight like an highlighter at the back side. You this is a fill color. Then click on a fill color. You can fill it. You can see over there at the back side, the data is coloring. Okay. You can fill it either whichever color you want. Okay. So like that. Same thing, I want to be highlight this heading, it is a rank, name, a network. I'll go by here, I'll select some of the light color. Okay, so as it is, you want to change the font color. There's whatever the list, there's a rank number, names of the richest persons, and this network. I want to be change the color, you can change the color. Okay, so if I want to highlight only this network, select the data, click on a color. Whichever color I want to highlight by the red, you can be highlighted. Okay, this is an highlighting. Next, I forgot to explain this border. Okay, this border is you are going to be want to be highlight this data by the border. Even though the cell is activated by the and the border, if you want to be highlight a data, if you see here, if I given a name network, if it's not an highlighted by the border. So if you want to be highlighted by the border, you can go by the border. You can see next to the border you have a drop down button. Click on a drop down button. Either you can be highlighted by the bottom, either you want to be highlighted at the top only, you can be highlighted. Okay, so these are the highlighting. If you want the all border, you can apply the all border. If you don't want the border, you can click on a no border. Automatically the border will be removed. If you want to be assigned a border, okay, just a second. If you want to be assigned a border, click on a border. Just copy this. I'll paste it over here. Now we can see. Yes. For this, I'm going to be assigned a border. Okay, I'll select the data. I want to be applied a for border. I'll select the border. I want only the down towards elevated down towards. Either I want the outside only. You can see that only outside has been highlighted. If you want to apply for all, you can select the border, apply all border. Okay, border will be applied. So this is we have a different kind of border we can be applied. And draw a border, that I will teach you in the insert tab. We have in the insert tab, we have a table. Under the table, I'll explain over there. That then draw table, okay? Next, we have a only a top, bottom rows. If you want to highlight, you can be highlighted this border, okay? So I think we have completed a format. There is an style. Default it will be font style. Default it will be in caliber. So we have changed it in the Algerian. Size will be default 11. We have changed in 5.5. This is an increase button. Increasing of font size or decreasing of font size. And this is called as in bold, italic, and the line. Control B is in bold. Italic is in control I. D is in. So underline, it's an control U, okay? So next we have an, okay, sorry. I didn't explain on the dialog box, okay? Let me go by the dialog box. So here we have some of the extra sub-commands. There's a strike, throw, and we have a substrate, superstrate. These things will get over in a dialog box. You can see in a font group, we don't have any substrate, superscript or strike. So we have a bold, italic or underline. Here we have an underline we can use here over here. Or we want a bold, you can make it a bold. Here font style we have, you can bold over here. Or if you want to give a color, you can give a color. Instead of that, except this one command you can view in a home tab. That except that if you want to find some kind of other command, in a dialog box it will be highlighted. If you want the other commands, you can search over here, okay? So just I'll give a and sub and command is an what is an water formula, that is an H2O, right? Represent the H2O. The two should be where? The two should be at the down towards in between of H and O. I'll select the two. I want to be present this two at the down towards. Go by the dialog box. In the dialog box in the effects, you will be having a subscript. So but subscript is an above the text. Superscript will be the above the text, subscript will be the below the text. Select the subscript, click on OK. Okay, so there's your, so can you see that H2O, the two is in below in between of text, how I have assigned it. So I just selected only the two, click on a dialog box of a font, okay, click on a subscript, click on OK. Okay, same as it is. A square plus B square, okay? A square plus B square. Where the two should be there? Two should be in a above part, okay? Select the two. Click on a dialog box of format. You can find a superscript. Select the superscript. Click on a okay, okay? Same as the second one also, B2. Select the word, click on a dialog box, click on a superscript, click on OK. Okay, this is nothing but, select the data, it's not selected. Click on a dialog box, click on a super shape, click on OK, which will be aligned. Okay. So if you have a strike in this, I don't want this Larry page. Okay, I want to be strike that person. You can select the name. You can go by the dialog box. Click on a strike through. Click on OK. Okay, this has been striker. So like this, if you want to remove, you need to go back to dialog box. To click on a strike through. Click on OK. It can be find it. Okay, this is your font. Okay, just give a one more shortcut key. For bold is an control plus B is an shortcut key. For italic, okay, control plus I is an shortcut key. For underline, okay, shortcut key is control plus U. Okay, make a note of it. Make a note of this shortcut key. I hope you have taken a screenshot or you have taken a note. Just we'll go by the next one. We have a alignment. Okay. In the alignment, we have a center alignment, left alignment, right alignment. Under the center alignment, down towards right, left towards center. Like this, we have a different kind of alignment. And also we have an orientation. But we have explained you orientation in a page orientation. We have a two types of orientation in Excel. One is a page orientation and one is a text orientation. Page orientation, you will be having a landscape or a project. I'll just show you. I go with a page in a orientation. You can see over here, portrait and landscape orientation we have. One more orientation is there. That is called as a text orientation. Okay. So that is, I'll show you, explain later. And back text we have and merging center we have. It's all the alignment group. Okay. First, let me go by the aligning in a center or right or left. Okay. I just select this name. Then I have given an annual loan amount and they have given a month in area and rate of interest. So I want to be aligned this at the center. So it's already aligned. I just extend this data. Okay. So this loan amount should be in a center. If you click on a center, it will be aligned in the center. And also it has been aligned here left towards. I don't want this left towards. I want to be aligned in the center towards only. You can find over here center and middle towards. Okay. Or this text, what it has been assigned, it has been assigned the left towards. I want to assign this to the center towards. You can select it. Click on a center at it is in down towards as I select into the center towards. Okay. This is an alignment in the center. Okay. So if you want in a left towards, you can assign a left, right, or middle, wherever you want to be aligned in that particular cell. Okay. I want to align this data in between of a cell, either the middle, either the left, either the right. You can be aligned it. Okay. So middle, right towards, I want a middle. I want at the left towards or down towards. I want wherever you want, you can be aligned. Or I want give this loan income at the an orientation. Means I want this name into the 360 degree or 160 degree. You can be changes. Or you want to give this as into the text zone orientation. Or I just select this. I just apply this for the cotton. Just extend this. You can see that here I have a product name. I want this cotton should be aligned at the down towards method. Just select it, text down orientation. You can see it has got a text down orientation. You have a different kind of orientation. You can be assigned it at the left towards, or I want to be aligned to the clockwise, or I want to be aligned the counter clockwise, reverse of a clockwise. You can be assigned it. Okay. So this order and orientation, or you want to be assigned according to your degrees, you can go by the format cell alignment. Under the alignment, you can find your orientation, I want to be align this in the 15 degree. Click on a 15 degree, click on OK, or you can find like this. I want to apply for all, you can be applied it. Okay, I'll just select the orientation. I want to be applied same for the pro or petrol, and just scroll the format as the table. I'll go by the and orientation. I just select, I want this should be in a 20 degree. Select that 20 degree. Click on OK. Okay, see, it's in petrol. So like this, you can align your data. I'm undoing it. Okay. So I just wanted to normal only. Still, it's an orientation form. Just unclick, I'll get in a normal form. Okay. So where you'll assign this? If I want into the other angles, you can go by the orientation. You have a different kind of text orientation, you can be aligned it. Okay, then we have a align this text into the different. So in case of I want to be aligned the center, I can align it in the center. Okay, I want to be aligned the at the right towards, at the left towards, I can move this. Okay, so I want it should be ended at the end, or I want to be moved to the totally at the left towards, I can be aligned this data and totally at the left towards. You can align this. Okay. Next, we have a back text. You can see I have given a product name. Okay. So where I can see in a name box, it has the full name rather than product name. But here I can view that only the product, a name is not properly presented. But I don't want to be, if I extend this, I don't want to be extend this to the column width. I want to be extend by the row width or cell width. I want to be increased or height, it has to be in this. So how I can be used this product name, it has to be fit in a particular cell only. You can go by the back text. Click on a back text, automatically it will be extended. I'll just show you by over here. You can see here it has an loan amount, here it has the month in year, here it have a rate of interest. So what if data I have presented, so I can't be previewed properly. So it, the same data has to be fitted in the particular cell. It could not be extended my data. If I extend it, I can't be printed up properly. So I want to be fitted in the particular cell only. Select the data, go with the VAP text, click on a VAP text. Once you have selected the VAP text, automatically the data will be fitted in the particular cell. This is a VAP text. Okay, next we have a alignment. Okay, so in we have a next and margin center. Okay, let me go with the margin center. Here have entered the sim of the employee list. There is an serial number, employee ID, there is an employee names, and I have given a designation, and I given a salary, I given a HR, and I given a DA, there is a DNS allowances. Okay. So, but I want to be the, what is the heading? You can see employee salary details have given over here. How would the heading should be there? It should be in a bold. I'll assign it to the bold, but it should be like a header. So what is a header? Header should be in a, assigned in the middle towards. Okay, it's not assigned the middle towards. If I want to assign to the middle towards, we have a margin center. Click on a margin center. You can see that if I cursor in a D, showing employee salary list. If I cursor in the same on the E4, it's not showing the data. Even though it's looking like an header only, but it's not displaying on all overall that what is an in a table. It's not looking under the table, the header isn't presented. So if you want to present this header, present this title on the header, so you can go with the margin center. Once you have selected the margin center, automatically it will be assigned as a header. Okay, so if you want to get back of it, you can click on a margin center drop down, click on a unmerge. Okay, so once you have selected the unmerge, automatically it will be replaced. If you want to merge, select it and click on a margin center, or you can click on a merge across. Once you have selected a merge across, it will be applicable, same thing. And merge cell, if you want to merge the cell, you can merge it. Okay, this is a margin center. Okay, any doubts in this till alignment? Any doubts in alignment? Any doubts in alignment or font? You can be chatting in a chat box. Till over here, whatever I have taught you right now. Any doubts you have? Or I want to repeat any other concept like MVAP text, text tone orientation, orientation, or any font proof. Any doubts you have? You can chat by the chat box. I didn't get any reply, so I'll continue with the next concept. That is a number group. Okay. So we have completed clipboard, font, alignment. Okay, in a number, yes, we have completed the alignment. Next, we have to go with the number. Okay. In a number group, we have an different kind of numbering, that is a general number, currency, accounting, data format, time format, percentage format. Let me see this one. Okay, just open our other book. Yes, just a second. Okay, now in a number group, so see, if I cursor in a number, it's in a blank cell. Wherever I'll cursor the cell, it's showing it's in general. Means if it's in a number or if it's anything, if it can be entered, okay? But you can see over here, wherever you cursor, it's in general. But if I write any amount, okay? If I write any amount, it's also in a number. But it has to be converted into the number format. It has to be converted in a currency format. You can select the range. You can click on a and general. Okay. Under general, you can see over here in a number formatting. If you click on a general, next to it, you have a number. Click on a number. Once you have selected the number, automatically it will display by the decimal format. You can see how many decimals are there? Two decimals are there. So just even though you can select the data or you can apply it, or you can write the data or you can give a value. And after you can apply into the number format. See, if I started to write any value, then 85,000, it will be converted. Okay, it will be converted into the number format. Okay, the same thing, whatever I have converted into the number format, it has to be converted into the currency. So if you want to convert this into the currency format, first you have to select the range. Range is nothing but D1 to D3 to D6, okay? Select the range properly. It is then D3 to D8 have selected. Go with the number formatting. Under that, you have a currency. Click on a currency. So once you have selected the currency, you get the and dollar symbol. Instead of, I don't want in a dollar, I want in a euro, you can select a euro. Or I don't want in a euro, I want in a yen format. That is Japanese currency. So you can select it. Or you see over here, I want in dollar format only, select the format only. But what I have given the dollar format, it has to be copied into the rupees. So how I can get here, can you see the any other currency dollar you have over here? Indian rupees dollar, I didn't find any Indian rupees dollar. So here also if I click on a currency, I'll get only the dollar. I won't get any Indian rupees. Okay, so if you want to get an Indian rupees, you need to go by the dialog box of our numbering. Okay, in a dialog box of numbering, you can see under the currency you have over here symbols. Okay, click on a symbol drop down button. Under that, just scroll down till you're getting in the Indian currency symbol. Okay, here we have all the country currency symbols: Greek, Japan, we have Thai, we have. And here you can find a and rupees. Just you need to scroll down. Once you have scrolled down, you will get an Indian rupee symbol. Select any one of it. Click on OK. Okay. Once you have selected, it will be converted. I'll just show you one more time. you click on a normal currency, it will be displayed only on by the dollar format or by the other type of currency. If you want to display by the Indian currency, select the value, go with the dialog box of numbering. Under the dialog box, you can find a currency, click on a currency. Under that symbol, at the down towards, on the drop down button, you click on a drop down button and scroll down. Till you're getting a Indian currency symbol, okay? So Indian currency selected, anyone you can select, if you can find the rupees, okay, rupees symbol. So this is here, how I can convert my dollar format to currency, rupees format, okay? Next, accounting we have, I just copy this data. In accounting format, if you want a data with the decimals, I'll remove this decimals. I don't want no decimals. I want the data with the dollar format with the decimals. You can go by the accounting format. You can click on an account. I get an accounting format. Okay. So next, we have a short date. So before I'm going to be write a short date, last class I have explained what is in shortcut of a shortcut key of inserting the date. So can anyone say by the chat box, what is the shortcut key of inserting of date? Shortcut key of inserting the date. Can anyone say by the chat box? Just wait for a few seconds. Is that all you are listening or you have... you have logged into the Zoom and you have left it. Shortcut key for inserting the date. Shortcut key for inserting of a date. Can anyone say by the chat box? Or there you can unmute and you can say.
Don't know.
Don't know. Okay, I'll only explain. Good. So shortcut key for inserting the date is nothing but control plus colon. Okay. Last class I have explained you date shortcut key. Control plus, you can use a control plus, you can use a colon. Okay. So if you want to insert the time, then shortcut key control plus shift plus colon. Okay. Semicolon. This is a shortcut key for inserting of a date and time. Okay. I just present the date now. If you want to present the short date, you can use your control plus colon. Okay. So select that value and hold a catch holder and drag and drop it. Okay. You'll find a next day. Okay. If you want a long date, I'll present the short date only. Just control colon at this cursor. Okay. But whatever has cursored over here, whatever I got a date, I should get the date in the format of first like a week name, that is on the Thursday, then I have to get it in February, then I have to get a month, then I have to get a year. So if you want in a long format of date, just click on a phone number formatting, click on a and long date. Once you have selected the long date, automatically it will show. It's on Thursday, it's in February 11, 2021. You can extend to the short date or long date. Or in case of you don't want this format, you have other format, I'll explain it later towards, okay? Then shortcut key for inserting the time, control plus, shift plus, colon, okay? So here it will be converted to the 24 format, okay? So next we have a, if you want to present other date also, you can be assigned it. See, in case of if I selected the range, if I click on a and a number formatting, if I click on a time, what I'm going to be write. If I write then 2, it will take a 2 a.m. 12 a.m. If I type the 5, it will take a 12 a.m. Okay. You can be changer. Or if I started to write, it's an 16 hour means it's an 10 o'clock or 8 o'clock. 16, right? Yes. So I'll give an 3 o'clock. Okay. 12, 13, 15, 16. Okay, 4 o'clock. I'll just write a 30 minutes. I'll just give a 20 seconds. Automatically it will take and 4:30. It will take and 12:20 format. Okay. I need to give a 24 format. Automatically it will assign into the 12-hour format. Okay, I'll just show you one more time. So if you want to give it now, it's an imagine, it's an 10 o'clock night. Just I'll give and 20, 22. It's an 15 minutes. I'll just give it's an 10 seconds. Okay, how it will be converted? Will be converted into the 12-hour format. So it's at 10 p.m. Okay, if I want to convert it in the a.m. format, so it's an imagine it's an 8 o'clock. So I'll give and it is an 22 minutes. I will give a 30 seconds. It will be converted into the AM format. Okay, you have to provide a 24 format. Automatically it will convert into the and 12 hour format. Okay, next and percentage. Okay, if you want to convert any data by the percentage format, you can be converted. Just add a value over there. You can select the range and you can click on a percentage. Here also you have. Or you can go by the and format numbering, and you can click on a format. Automatically it will be converted. Or you can select the range. You can select the range. Click on a formatting, or you can type the data. So once you have click on a enter, automatically it will be assigned. In case of you don't want this decimal, select it. Click on a backspace. Okay. So remove the decimals. If you want to add multiple decimals, you can be added. If you don't want, you can be remove the decimals. Okay, so then we have a fraction. This is again drag and drop it. Next we have a fractions. Okay, what is fractions? There is an 1:2, 3:4. If you want to assign, you can assign it. Okay, I'll just write a data 0.5 something and 0.32 have 0.85, 0.360, 0.85. Okay, I'll just select this data and I can convert it to the fractions method. Click on a fractions, it will be converted to the fraction method. Okay, so next we have a commas. So if you want to specify the comma size, you can specify. For example, if I give a value, is that if I give a 20 lakh or if I give a 50 lakh, it already assigned the comma format. I'll just remove this. In case of if it's not converted, I'll convert it in a general format. Yes. I just had a 60,000. I'll add a 85,000. I'll add a 96,000. Now, if it's an value, if it start by the 2 lakh, it should be specified by the commas, or if you want to specify by the decimals, select the range. Select the range. If you want to specify by the commas, click on a comma. Now it's unspecifying. It's an after 3 decimals we have to get a comma, right? So we have got it. Okay, it's in comma specification. Next we have a decimals. I'll just copy this data and I'll paste it over right over here. We have a answer of 3 decimals. If you want to add, here we have an increasing of decimals, you can add it. If you want to decrease, select the value, click on a decreasing of decimals, you can add or you can be removed it. Okay, I think you have clear how to add a decimals. In case of what you have got an text format, okay, have got it with the and DDD format, and you got with the and month format MMM, and you got with the and day format, and you got an year format. This is a format what we have got in a previous lesson. DDD means what? What is an MMM? What is in this YYY? I'll just explain it. Okay. I have write a data over here. That's the date I'll give. It is in control plus colon. I want to convert this into this long test format. Either you can go by the series, you can click on a long test format. Or if you want to change it to different format, you can go by the and dialog box of a number. You can click on a customize. You can find over here. DMMMY is nothing but you'll get a date and you'll get the month name and you'll get the year format. Okay, I'll just show you. I'll write that. I'll give a date over here. See this date, how it will be converted. I'll go by the customized data format. I'll just scroll down. Customize. I'll just scroll down. Say this. It is as a D. A D is nothing but undate. MMM is nothing but month. If you give on a M only, I'll just get as an 02, 03, 04. If I give on a triple times M, I'll get a month name. That is a short time. If it's in January, I'll get a Jan. If it's in February, I'll get a Feb. Okay. It is a three times of M. If you give on a Y, Y. Twice if you give on a Y, it will present it only the 21. It's in 2021. So it will present only the 21. If you present the Y three times, it will be presented. And 2021. I'll just show you. See, it's in how it's predicting. It's in date, it's in month, it's in year. Okay. So see how it has been presented. It's in date. It's in presented month first, date second, it's in year last. Okay. You can be converted. So how I can convert in a different method, I'll just show you. Go with the number box. Under the number box, you can go by the custom. Under the custom, select and this slash cursor. Okay, you can be edit this slash. This in a type box, I'll edit it. So just concentrate on the sample data. I want to change the data format, that is in DDD format. See, if I click on a one time date, I'll get, that is in today is in 11. Okay, if I cursor one more time date, it will be presented date only. If I cursor on one more time D, it will be presented, it's in Tuesday, means it's showing by the short M. If I cursor one more time D, it will be presented by the Thursday. It's in full name, it will be presented. Comma or colon, if you want to give colon, you can present the code, or iPhone, you want to present, you can present the iPhone. With that, I want a month name. What is in month? It's in February. If I give an M at the one time, I'll get a 2. It's in January, February, it's in second month. Okay. If I type one more M, this it will be added by the 02. Okay. If it's in December, it will show by the 111. If it's in February, it's showing in 02. It's in sample. If I give on a one more M, it will be presented by the short month name. If I present a one more M, that is in four times M, if I present it, it will be described by the overall and full name. Okay. I'll give a comma, or I want a date. Just present a date, the present, I will get a date. Next, I'll do a hyphen. Next, I want to present the year. See, if I present the Y one time, I'll get a 2021. If I type a one more Y, I'll just same thing I'll get. If I type a one more Y, I'll get the overall 2021. Means DDD. If you type the only the 2D or 1D, it will be presented only the date, that is 01 or 02. If you give it a three times, it will be presented by the only the short name. If you want to present a long name, then you have to present it four times D. Same as it is, a month, I have given a four times. I want a date, I want a year, okay? Click on the OK. You want to be assigned this into the, I want it should be a DD format. I want DDD format and I want it should be a MM format. And I want it should be a D format and also I want a Y format. Means I'll get a day, I'll get a month, I'll get a date, I'll get a year. Okay. This cursor over here, I'll go by the dialog box of a form number. I'll go by the customize. Select the same thing previous what we have selected. It is three times slash selected and edit it in a type bar. You want which format? I want a DDD format. You can see that. Thus, they'll get MM format. Only the month number has to get. And D is a date. And I want in a year. That's in 2021 only I want. You can be change it. Okay. So, this is the formatting of numbering. Okay. Next is the numbering. Next, we have a condition formatting. Okay. I think we have cleared in this. Okay. Next, we have a condition formatting. Okay, in a condition formatting, we have a other concept like an highlighter rules, we have a top bottom rules, we have a data bar, we have a color scale, icon set. Okay, so the other sub commands we have in a conditional formatting, okay, which are highlighter rules, top bottom rules, and data bar, we have a color scale, we have a icon set. See, here I have gotten some of the age of the persons that I have from the 6 age to I have till 90, okay, from the 69 age to 90 age I have. This is my range. In this my range I have to be highlighted, okay, I want to be highlight the person who got greater than at 98. I want to be highlighted by the sum of the color, or I want to be highlighted by the whoever got a lesser than and 35 or lesser than 30 age, whoever have, I want to be highlighted by the sum of the other color, okay. Or I can say other either I can take other format. Just give me a second, I'll enter the data. And then I'll enter the student's marks list. Name of the student. Name of the student. I'll add over your subject. It's an subject 1, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, subject 5. And subject 5, and I'll add a subject 6. Okay, so I want to write a name, well, that already I have explained you how to use a custom data. So if I write my name, or if I give any brand name, so if I want to drag and drop, or it will be aligned. So this I have created by the custom list. The previous class only I have explained it. Okay, next we have a subject. In a subject, I have to present the marks. Instead of typing the marks name, I'll use a line between. I'll use a line between, that is 10 to, or I want 20 to 100. I want 20 to 100. I want. Okay, I'll just. Okay, 100. I want. I'll just write it. Hundred, close the bracket, enter. Okay, I'll select the range.
Yes.
I'll drag towards side towards. I'll drag towards down towards.
One second, do the next.
Someone has been activated. Please mute by yourself.
Yes.
One more time. If I saw the again, if you have unmuted, I'll take action against you. Okay. So next we are going to be do a condition formatting under that highlighter cell rules. Okay. I'll select the data. Okay. In this, it's nothing but conditional formatting. You have a some condition around that you're going to be formatting your data. How? I'll just show you. Here have a some of the condition. The students who were got a greater than 35, sorry, or greater than 70, I should be highlighted. Okay, I just had over here the student whoever got the greater than 70, I should be highlighted by the green color. And the student whoever got and lesser than 35, I should be highlighted by the red color. The student whoever got and more than 35, more than 35. Less than 70, it should be highlighted by the yellow color. Okay, this is my condition. On this my condition, I need to be formatted this. So I given a formatting color. So select the, you need to select only the value. You should not select any kind of heading. It is a subject name, or you should not select any kind of name. It is select only the value, that is that B39 to G50 have selected. Select the value, go with the condition formatting under that highlight rules. Okay, in the highlight cell rules, you have first greater than. Select the greater than. Okay, it has been taken the average number, that is 60.5 has been selected. I don't want, I want to give given 70 marks. Click on a 70. The student who are got a 70, it should be highlighted. But here only it has been taken a first formatting, that's a light red fill and dark red it has been taken. I don't want this. I want to be fill a green only, okay? I just drop down on the format as, click on a custom format. Here only have a green fill, dark text, you can select it. Or I don't want, I want to be formatted with a different, you can go by the custom format. Once you have selected the custom format, you'll get a dialog box of a format, okay? So you want a which color? I want to be fill it in a green color, okay? I want to give a border, okay? Select the outside border, and if you want to assign the color of it, you can select the color. I want to be filled by the and purple, okay? I want to give a different border, that is and dotted border or line border, whichever border you want, you can select it. And the font, what you can see that number, it should be color display with the and black color, okay? And it has to be underline, okay? Double underline or single underline. Whatever you want, you can make it. I want to be assigned in the bold letter, okay? Select it, click on OK. Click on OK. This is a formatting. Can you check, is that any value which is an highlighted by the green color more than or less than 70? You cannot. Why? Because I have given a condition in this particular range, the student whoever got a greater than 70, only that student has to be, that number has to be highlighted by the green fill color. Okay. And also I have given a border, that is a purple border I have given, font double bold I have given, font black I have given. Like this, you can be formatted. In the same data, I want to give a second condition. So what is the second condition? Lesser than 35, the students who were got the, and 35, it has to be highlighted by the red fill, okay? So with the condition formatting, under the highlight cell, you'll get a lesser than. Click on a lesser than. Same, it will select an average number with the and default color. Change it in a 35. Lesser than 35, it should be filled with what color? Red color. So here I have a red text, I don't want a text, I need to provide a filling. So I can go by the format as painter, click on a fill, click on a color. I want to be highlighted by the red fill. Same thing, if you want to be highlighted by the border, you can select the border. The text should be in a different color, I want to be display the text in a green color. Click on a OK. So click on OK. Once you have to give a configuration screen, you have to give this one also. You need to click on OK. Now can you see? Less than 35 only it has been highlighted. So and also you can see some of the numeric values and in between of 35 to 70 it is not highlighted. It can be presented by the only the in a blank format. So if you want to be highlighted, select the data, go with the condition formatting. In the highlight rules, you have a between. Click on a between. Now you get a format as cell. Okay. Click on a format as cell. Here, the least number is then from 70 to the student whoever got, sorry, from 35 to the student whoever got till 70, okay? It should be highlighted by what? Yellow fill. So here I have a yellow with a dark light. You can select it, or if you want to assign the border, you can go by the custom format. In a fill, select the fill which you want. I want a yellow fill. Or I want to be assigned a border, or you want to be filled by the text color, you can be filled by the text color, or you want to be double underline, or I want to be underlined by the single, select it, click on OK, click on OK. There's a condition formatting. According to your condition, you are going to be format your data. Okay, this is a condition formatting. Where I'll get this all thing, I'll get this in condition formatting. In a highlighting cell, you'll get here. Condition, that is a greater than, lesser than, between, and we have a equals to. Here, in this set of data, we have a sum of the and double data we have. For example, any one of the double value we have. I find that 27 is not there. 84 is there. Oh yes, you can see here, 84, it has a double times. So I want to be highlight this 84, okay? Select the data, go with the condition formatting, go with the highlight rules. equals to. Okay, click on equals to. Equals to which is an value equals to 84. Okay, click on 84. You can see which has been highlighted with the and a different color or format. You can select the format which you want to be filled. Select it. Click on OK. Okay, so which has been highlighted with a different color. So in your data, it is an and duplicate value which has been repeated, you can be highlighted. Okay, where you'll get in a condition formatting, highlight under the highlight, you'll get into the data that equals to we have completed. Then we have a text that contain. Okay, so we have to select and different data for this. For greater than, lesser than, we have to select by the value, that the numeric value we have to select. Text that contain we have to select by names or the text we have to be selected. A data that occur, we have to select the date format of data. Okay, so you can't be assigned this this what we have selected the data. Okay, so here I have given a sum of the data text. Okay, so here I have given a and week names, that is on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, till a week names I have given. In this data I want to be highlighted only the Tuesday. I can go by the text that contain. It's already taken a Monday. I don't want to be highlight a Monday. I want to highlight a Tuesday. Just present a GUV. Okay. So give a which format you want. You know, right? How to format it. Go with the custom format. Go with the fill. If you want to fill it or I want to highlight with a different text color, select the which color you want. Click on OK. Okay. Click on OK. So you have to give twice. If you do on a one time, it won't be accepted. You want to be accepted twice. Okay, so it's a condition formatting. So it's a highlight rules under that text cut that contain, that contain. Okay, so next we have a data occur. For that I have arranged some of the date over here. Select the date, go with the condition formatting under that date that occur. In that date occur, so you can find here it's showing it's an yesterday. If you want to present today date, you can go by the today. So in a dialog box of date that occur, you can click on in a formatting cell below. You'll be having a and week names, month names. You just select it today. Or if you want and last week data, you can click on a last week. Or if you want this week data, you can select the this week. Next month data, if you want, you can select it. Or this month data, I want, I can select it. Imagine we have an employees salary list, or imagine you have a sales according to the date data you date you have, means 1 month data sales data you have. You want to be highlighted, or which last week I have did this much of production, this week I have did this much of production. That you can be explained by this kind of data. Okay, so this week you can be highlighted, or today, so today I have did this much of production. So it can be explained by this data that occurs. See, if you didn't click on OK, automatically it won't be highlighted. So I'll click on a data that occurs. See, if I want to be highlighted this way, without accepting this, if I click on a close, it won't be highlighted. Okay, it should be seen carefully. Then we have a duplicate value. Yes, here in the list of names which has been repeated. Okay, you know that what is a unique or what is a duplicate. Unique which has a single name, a double name which has been presented, which will be highlighted. For example, I'm copying my other data from one page to other page, which is then whichever it has been highlighted by that twice. Okay, you can be highlighted that. Okay, you can go by the data that the duplicated. So here you can see it's then duplicated. See, for example, Divya, Sonia, Omshi, Monica, which has been repeated. If you click on a drop down of it, you can click on a unique. You can find an unique kind of, I mean single value data you can be presented. So if you click on a double value presented, unique returns and single data will be presented. This is a condition formatting. Okay. Enough today. What we have did the condition formatting. I'll just give you the assignment. This top or bottom rules, data bar, color scale, icon set. These are the concepts I'll be did with the next class. Okay. So, but I'll give you some of the assignment of today, whatever we have worked. I'll just forward this assignment, or you just take a screenshot of it. Just you can take a screenshot of it. Either I'll send you this in a WhatsApp group. Only 10 students, very good strength. See, the attendance cannot be taken at the beginning or the middle. Attendance will be taken at the end of the session only. Okay, so all that has to be attended till end. Okay, who are the participant who has been participated at the till end of the session only, I'll give attendance. Who will come middle? Someone will come at the middle, who will get an go by the at the middle only, when within half an hour, within 1 hour, for them I won't give any attendance. So at the end of the 3:45, I'll just take a and screenshot who are the participant, then that time I will take attendance. Till that I won't take attendance. Okay, so all it has to be participated till 4 o'clock. So take a screenshot of it. I just explain you how to assign this assignment. So here I have given you some of the assignment. There is an assignment one. You have to open your new workbook, and you have to be saved on my document, which has to be named as in lab assignment one. Folder should be assigned in your name. Okay. So second in assignment, you have to be protect that workbook by the password 123. Okay. And you have to be create this data. Rather than explaining, I'll just show you this. I'll go by the new workbook window. Click write Excel. Click on OK. In a run prompt, you have to give an Excel. Once you have opened the data, you need to save this. Control S is a shortcut key. You need to browse. You need to save this in a document as in lab assignment one. Okay. After saving it is a lab assignment one. The assignment 2, what I have provided, okay? The assignment 2 is then you need to be protect your workbook. That is also you have did in the last class. Again, you have to do in this. So, protect the workbook by the password 123, okay? Go with how I can protect it. And to go by the file tab and to go by the info. Under that, you have protect workbook. Click on protect current workbook and the directory with the password. Give a password. Re-enter the password, save it. Okay, then third assignment has been completed. Next, you have to be enter this data. Okay, so here I have given the Anand Sagar College in 2021. I have given the list of series name, and I have given a class, and I have given a marks. Okay, I'll just edit over here. You need to be type what I have given exactly same thing. Okay, Dayananda Sagar College. Okay. Present 2020-2021 have given, and have given a serial number, write the serial number, give a serial number, that is 001. How I have given in my data, same as it is, you have to follow. Select these two data and drag and drop. Okay. Next, you have a name of the student, type a name of the student, give a name of the student. Select it. And drag and drop it. Okay. And I just give a class. It is on first BCom, second BCom, or first. I just give a first BCom only. First BCom or fifth BCom D section. I'll just provide it. So same class. I'll just select it and I'll drag and drop it. Okay, it has been increased. And I have to give a marks. Okay, so that it will be marks. Okay, I'll give a marks. 152, 394. I give on the marks. Okay, and in my data, I have explained you after writing of it, you have to select the cell from A1 to D1. Where is my A1 to D1? You can go by the sheet. You have to select A1 to D1. Here I have specified. In case of you didn't get that, where is that A1 to D1, you can cursor in a name of, you can type an A1 is to D1. You can type it, automatically it will be selected. Okay, sorry. A1 is to D1. Okay, click on enter, it will only select. Either if you didn't get where is an range, you can type over in the name box. Okay. Select the A1 to D1 that I'll show you. I'll cursor in A1. From that, you have to select till D1. Okay. And what it has been explained, go with the home tab, select the alignment, click on a merging center. Same thing you have to do. Select the data, go with the home tab, go with the alignment, click on merging center. Okay. If that's it. What you have to do, I have given an explanation over there. You have to go by the home tab. Under the home tab, you have to go with the alignment. Under the alignment, you have to click on the merging center. After that, you have to align it Algerian font and 15 size. Okay. Let me go here. Same thing. Don't select other data. Select the same data. Go with the font style. That is an Algerian. You need to select. It has been specified. Okay. Select the Algerian font. Just give a font size as in 50. Okay. Click on enter. It's also completed. Next, we have assigned to the board yellow fill, blue font. Okay, it has to be outside the board. You can click on a B or you can click on a Control B shortcut key. And also, it has to be filled with the yellow and agivan and blue font color. Okay, select the font color, assign the blue. Like this, you have to be filled. And also, you just see it's not having enough space. It's not having enough space. You just need to be double tap on the cell. Okay, just double tap, or you can extend the data, or you can extend your cells. Okay, you can extend your cells. Okay, so next we have given, select the cell from A2 to D2. Where have given? Here have given A2 to D2. Okay, or you can select, or you can click on a name box, you can type over there. Okay, so go with the A2 to D2, apply italic times new row. Okay, select the data, click on a italic, control I also you can click, or you can click on a italic. And what I have given, times new row font and green fill. I select the times new row, you can select, or you can type over in a style. Times New Roman, click on enter font, and also green fill. Go with the fill color, select the and green fill. Okay, whatever the light or blue color, you can select it. Okay, then red the text. Text down orientation. You know where is that text down orientation? Yeah, it's an orientation. If you didn't get that, you can cursor in a every one command. You can get it. It's in back text as we mentioned. So it's not mentioned. It's an orientation. If you cursor on it, it will only explain. Okay. So click on the orientation, click on a text down orientation. Okay. So it has been completed, and also we have to give a font color that is in red color. Okay. Like this, you have to be complete with your assignment. And also I have given at the end, the fourth assignment, you have to select your data, and it has to be pasted in a new sheet, and also it has to be pasted in a different format. As I have I have explained, it has to be pasted without formula, without transpose, no border, autofill content value. Like this, it has to be pasted. Okay, I'll just show you. Go with the Excel book, select your data, copy it, cursor where you want to be pasted, or I have explained you have to be pasted in a new sheet. So if you want to insert the new sheet, what you have to do, you have to click on Shift F11. Okay, in the Shift F11, you have to be paste. Okay, paste here you have different kind of paste. If you cursor on the individual icon, you can set that. Okay, it's in paste as in formula. Here you have to be paste same as it is. First, you have to be paste like it. Keep source formatting. Where the keep source formatting, you can find it. If you cursor on the everything, it will be explained. Here you have a keep source as in formatting, click on it. Okay, cut that down. It has a one more argument. Paste like in formula. Okay, go with the Excel. Click on a paste special. Yeah, with formula. Click on it. Okay, next I have given paste as in transpose. Cursor here, paste with the transpose. Here you have. You just need to cursor on the every icon. It will only explain. This is a paste. Okay, paste like in transpose. Next I have given paste with no border. Okay, so cursor, paste, no border. Okay, like this. You have to be finish your assignment and it has to be sent it by the same mail ID. Okay, so I'll just forward this assignment to you. Okay, by the today I'll just forward this in the WhatsApp group. Okay, now anyone have a doubt what we have discussed today? Is that anyone have a doubt?
When will the recorded video be uploaded on YouTube, ma'am?
Send it within 2 days, pa. It will be converted by the head office. I'll be sending by the within 2 days. Don't worry.
Thank you, ma'am.
That past class also, so I have taken the second session. That is, on first class is an orientation. We don't want second class. I'll forward it. Okay, don't worry. Why this?
It'll be from second class, ma'am.
Sorry.
It'll be from second class, no.
Yeah, I'll send it by the second class. I'll just check whether if it's possible to send the first session. I'll send the first session. Just a second. I'll take our attendance. Only 8 members have attended. You just say with your friend. Anjun Gupta, Akash Kumar, Ananya, and Neha. Only 9 members is attending. Only for them I'll take our attendance. So who were not attended, say that. Only 8 students have been attended the today class. Okay, I'm giving a report for your coordinator or your principal. The same report. Only the 8 student has been attended the today class. See, it's a 2-hour session. You have to be listen the 2-hour session. Okay. So if it's emergency, I'll leave as soon. Okay. So before 10 minutes, I'll leave the class. It's a very worst condition. Only the 8 students till end of the class. Okay. From the next time, I'll take the end of the at the end only, I'll take attendance. It's better. So why this much of strength? Can anyone has been unmute and you can explain why this much of strength? Out of 48 students, we have only the 8 students.
Few of them might be attending the webinar, ma'am. There's a webinar going on.
Webinar.
So they might be attending that.
Webinar is also going?
Yes, ma'am. Some
webinar. Which webinar, pa? Which subject, pa?
It's not subject, ma'am. It's some job related.
Okay. But we have to attend this session also, right? Only have gotten 8 or that exactly at 2:30 I'll get a 20 to 30 students. I'll get at the end of the session I'll get only the 8 or 9 students. It's not very nice. Okay, so just say that at the Saturday all you have to be attend the class, or in case of you not attending in the next class on Saturday, I'll take a serious condition. Okay, I'll take a serious action against you. Okay, so I just wanted all to be attend the class till 4 o'clock. Okay, so it's not good. So I'll speak with your concerned person. Okay, so all at the next Saturday, all 30 or whoever the students who have full strength, it has to be attended. Okay, just practice this one. I'll send this data through WhatsApp to practice today. In case of if you got the doubt, you can chat in a chat box. Or you can message me in your WhatsApp group, or if you can't be chat in a group, you will be having on my mail ID, that is anudia@divyanict.com. You can chat over there. Just I'll reply it. Okay. So and the notes, the assignment, it has to be sent in the same ID. It's anudia@divyanict.com. That one only have to be sent the assignment. Okay. So I'll just wind the class. We'll meet you on by the Saturday. So just explain your friends that only the 8th student has been attended the today class. Okay. For them only has been the attendance. Okay. Thank you. See you on by the next class. On by Saturday. Bye. Have a good day.